Welcome to an overview of the new features in ZePrA 10. The Auto Setup Wizard has a new mode called Copy and Change an Existing Configuration. While the Auto Setup Wizard is popular for creating new configurations and queues, often the same changes need to be made repeatedly in new configurations. This is why we believe it's a good idea to use an existing configuration that has been set up already as a base to build a new configuration from with just a change of profiles. When selecting an existing configuration in the wizard, insights are provided such as which profiles are used for the document and target color spaces, the conversion method, and the configuration type. In the next step, new profiles can be selected which have to be of the same type and color space as the original profiles. For example, if the base configuration uses SmartLink, the copied configuration will also use SmartLink. This leads me to another new feature in ZePrA. The superior color quality of ZePrA comes from using device links and the ColorLogic rendering intents. There are new advanced rendering options to ZePrA SmartLink. Use the automatic paper absolute for best-in-class color conversions for a gray balance that compensates the paper tint, or use automatic paper relative if you like to have a gray balance with a paper tint. In the final step of the wizard, the new configuration and queue name will be defined. You will find that in the new configuration, all the additional settings such as spot color conversion, flattening, or PDF layers settings from the original configuration are maintained. Another great new feature is the ability to change configuration settings on a job-by-job basis in a fast and simple way. In addition, there are new features in the context menu in the overview dialog for the queues and pending jobs. Use the new feature Add Files to Queue and Hold to add one or multiple files. Instead of processing the files right away, they are put on hold in the pending jobs list. When selecting the job and opening the context menu, four new options appear. The Attached Job Control File option refers to another great new feature for automation, which is covered in a separate video. The link to this video is provided in the comments below. Modify Configuration for this job opens a new dialog to define the configuration to be used for this job. This is helpful to change settings for single jobs without having to create a new configuration. You may also change the base configuration here. By default, the configuration associated with the selected queue is pre-selected. If you want to make additional modifications, all you have to do is enable the checkbox and click OK. A temporary copy of the configuration opens in a separate dialog that appears to be similar to the typical Define Configurations dialog with all options for editing the settings. Note that the top area of the dialog is different. Under Name, the currently used configuration is shown with an indication that this configuration is temporarily modified for the selected job. I will modify the desired settings, for example, changing the target profile, and I will change the name of the modified job-specific configuration for easier recognition later on. Once I am done with editing, I click Apply to confirm. The dialog will close and ZePrA will revert back to the overview dialog. To start processing the job with the modified settings, select Release Job from the context menu. Keep in mind that the edits will be applied to this one job only. ZePrA is among the very few PDF and image previewing applications that allows a true color preview of multicolor PDF and image files. Please keep in mind that a large gamut monitor must be used, calibrated, and profiled. As soon as the monitor profile is set in the operating system, it will be used for displaying in the screen preview. The selected PDF file that I am showing here has been converted to 7 process colors, and we are seeing a true color preview with paper simulation. In the color management settings available with this icon, I can see the simulation profile being used. By default, the target profile or output intent set in the configuration of ZePrA will be applied automatically. With the checkbox, I can enable or disable the paper white simulation and apply my changes. The spot color report allows to automatically determine the best configuration from a list of selected configurations to match the spot colors of one or several jobs. I've selected 2 PDF files and 4 configurations, all printing on the same HP Indigo digital press on a foil. One configuration is using CMYK inks only, the others are using 5, 6, or 7 inks. The question is, which of these four configurations results in the best color rendering and provides less costs? Clicking the preview button will start the calculation. ZePrA 10 is using a refined method that takes the average Delta E2000, the max Delta E2000, and the number of channels into account. For example, if the spot colors of this cat food job can be processed equally well with less processed colors compared to 7 inks on the same press, then the configuration using 6 processed colors, in this case, is the best, because it saves on inks and costs during production. The configuration with the highest score for the given job will be listed under Best Configuration. And by the way, when I click the Process Files button, the two files are sent to the corresponding best configurations for processing. ZePrA allows processing of entire subfolders added to the input folder of a queue. Typically, the files from that subfolder will be processed and the same subfolder name will be created in the output folder with the processed files in it. With the new feature Retain Subfolders in the Input folder, under Folders in the Define Queues, it is possible to leave the empty subfolder in the Input folder. This allows dropping new files belonging to those workflows into the existing subfolders in order to maintain the original structure of files. In the Transparency Flattening dialog, there are two new features that deal with files that need a very long time for flattening. The default maximum time slot that ZePrA allows for flattening before it actually cancels the flattening process is 30 minutes. However, some PDF files with lots of transparency constructs may need more than 30 minutes. The time that ZePrA grants for flattening to process the file can be prolonged now by entering a larger number of minutes. For some problematic files, there is an additional checkbox that enables rasterization of the file if the timeout is exceeded. Sometimes rasterizing is the only resort to convert problematic files correctly. If the Rasterize After Timeout checkbox is on, the settings from the grayed out section Rasterize Document are used. If a defined setting should be used, you may change the rasterizing settings in the dialog before applying Rasterize After Timeout. Finally, ZePrA 10 runs natively on the new Macs with the M1 processor, which improves the speed of processing, especially when calculating smart link profiles. That being said, ZePrA runs on the most recent Mac OS 12 and on Windows 11.